there, this is Yivvits of the podcast Star Wars Galaxies with Yivvits and Mr. Bubble. Since 2005, we've been your source for all sorts of Star Wars Galaxies and Star Wars related information and comedy. Visit our podcast site at www.swgpodcast.com to subscribe to our show or download almost any of our past episodes. You can also find us in iTunes. Our forums and community site is at www.yivvitsandmrbubble.com. And if you'd like to leave us a voicemail message, our toll-free number is 888-900-YAMB or 9262. You might just hear your message on the next episode of our show. Now, you've probably realized that this isn't an actual episode of our podcast, but it is a recording of one of the Star Wars Galaxies discussion panels from Fanfare 2009 in Las Vegas. This was the Next Big Thing panel, where the developers announced the Chronicles system, which will allow us to create our very own quests. You'll also get to hear really exciting things like me rustling around my backpack for a piece of minty gum. How exciting is that? Thanks for listening, and enjoy.
And thanks to all of you guys for coming to Fanfare 2009!
Yeah.
All
right!
In several years, so it's pretty exciting for us this year. I wanted to open the panel really quickly with a couple of announcements that I think you'll be excited to hear about. But first, I want to introduce some of the people that are here with us in case everyone doesn't know who they are. Our panel is Michael Ferrone, designer, Star Wars Galaxies. And we also have Matt Boudreau, programmer, Star Wars Galaxies.
Matt Boudreau. All right.
And somewhere in the audience, I think we just saw Dracul, who's our new community manager. And I believe we have Tony Tyson somewhere in the audience. Did I see him come in? Our lead programmer and technology. Tony, how many years have you been working on Star Wars Galaxies?
5 years.
5 years. Almost 1 year. And then they may want to stay incognito, but we do have our partners, without whom we wouldn't be here, from LucasArts. We have our producer for Star Wars Galaxies, Tim Temmerman. We have our PR manager from LucasArts for Star Wars Galaxies, Chris Cook. And we have the most passionate and enthusiastic marketing manager for Star Wars Galaxies, Patrick Alvarado. I wanted to make a couple quick announcements. One, we wanted you to know that at the store inside the main ballroom where the station store has a booth, we have some really cool posters. It's a 24 by 36 high-res beautiful version of the smaller piece of key art that you got in your goodie bags. So if you're interested in purchasing one for framing that's a little higher quality, they're there at the station store. Also, we have 5th anniversary t-shirts for purchase. I know we're lucky to be celebrating our 6th anniversary this year. And we have 6th anniversary t-shirts in the works. They're coming. And they will be in the station store as well. So we'll put out an email and we'll post on the forums when those shirts become available. And one other thing that we wanted to announce is our brand manager who's here, Chris Binky Lanius, somewhere in the room.
Yeah.
He worked in the back. He worked with our dev team on putting together a customized version of the Mighty Mugs. And everyone on the development team actually painted and customized a Mighty Mug. And they are for bid for the charity auction. Also, in I think they're in the main ballroom, in a section at a table along the back, I believe, is where you can bid on these. It goes to charity, and each one was done by a different development team member, and they're very cool. Very, very cool. So if you haven't seen them, at least go check them out. And let's see, was there anything else I was supposed to announce, Binky?
Yes.
Oh, and Jesse, our lead designer, is in the back right here. So we're real excited about this panel. We hope you are too. And thanks again for coming. We really value you guys. And, you know, go Galaxies.
So after the release of Hoth, the Battlefield Base, together with LucasArts, those of us at SWG, started talking about what we should do next. What's the next big system or big fun event we can do in the game? We wanted to draw on iconic characters, something that's potentially soloable, repeatable, and it could be added to in the future. So this is not really the first version isn't the final version. You keep going on and on and on. And we're pretty excited about both LucasArts and we're excited about it. It's something that was derived from an idea that had come up a long time ago that kind of turned into the storyteller stuff that we already have in the game, but goes a thing a lot further. And we're calling it Star Wars Chronicles. It's a system that's a player-generated content system that allows you guys to actually generate quests within the game that you can allow other people to play through and tell your stories in a more robust way.
Hold it closer, okay.
Star Wars.
Go back. You'll be able to, so there's a new profession, it's the Chronicle Master profession that you'll be able to go through as you learn and get better at making quests, I guess. And it opens up more possibilities to you. And you can then, as you make your quests, you can burn them onto Chronicle Holocrons, is what we're calling them, and you can trade them and sell them and give them to other players who can then run through your events and your quests without you having to meet it. And there's going to be a professional version. So creating a quest, this is the interface that Matt's been working on to allow you to build it. It shows tasks along the side that you can choose from, and then in the middle is where you actually put in your own custom text for a title and descriptions and various other things. And to build your quest, you'll use a variety of tasks that we'll make available to you. This is part of the collection, part of the game, where you will actually obtain the various relics that you can use to become tasks, or you can trade them if you already have them. And these will be looted, purchased, traded, you can give in various ways. We'll try to make it as appropriate to the kind of tasks there are as possible. And as you gain these, it will expand the kinds of tasks that you can put in your quest to allow you to make better and more intricate quests for your questers. I would say once you've started gathering your Chronicle relics, you can begin building your quest. You'll need the relics before you can actually use them. That's where the collection comes. You can then arrange them, customize the text, flip it back and forth, whatever kind of order and story you want to tell, allows you to tell your story via this system. And we're also going to put in a system to allow you to create a draft, a Chronicle draft, so that as you're working on your quest, you can test it and play through it yourself and change it, iterate on it until you get a final version that you've been ready to burn onto a holocron and play with other people. It's another version of the quest builder, the Chronicle builder. As you craft quests, not only will the crafter get Chronicler XP towards their own progression, but the people who run your quests will get rewards and XP as well. And they'll be based on how difficult the quest is, the variety of tasks put in, and the length of the quest, among other things, which will allow players to benefit from your quest as well, just like any other quest. The point here is to make it so that it's like any other quest in the game, only you guys make to tell your own story. You can also choose to offer your own quest, your own rewards. There'll be rewards within the system, but if you have some items that you want to give out, regardless of what they are, you can add them here in the little quest boxes, in addition to throwing in some of your own credits that you can donate to your quest so that people can earn those things when they complete them. And then as you finish your quest, you'll burn them onto a quest holocron that looks something like this. And of course, people will want to play your quest. Doing so, as I said, it's basically the same. We want it to be feel and look the same as every other quest in the game, using the quest journal and the quest helper, so that it's just like running a quest, any other quest. Only it comes from a different source. The quest holocrons will be something that you have in your inventory, and when you act, then you'll activate it and go on from there, which you'll see. At the end of a quest, you're allowed to rate the person who made the quest to help people understand what kind of quality this person is putting out, so you can know, well, this guy has a lot of great quests because he has a good rating, and maybe this guy needs a little more practice. That'll also help determine bonuses for the quest master. As the Chronicle Master has people run through his quests more and more, he'll get bonus XP every time they finish it. So just not just craft from crafting it, but also from people actually finishing their quests when you progress in their profession. And potentially other benefits as well. And one of the exciting parts is we're actually going to include iconic characters in this. You can have people like Darth Vader, Han Solo, Boba Fett, Jabba the Hutt, and potentially more and more that can be part of your quest. They can show up as these comm windows like you see Jabba here that you've seen before. And you will actually be able to write what they say and have them come to life as part of your events.
Really?
They'll be featured as comm relic messages at the moment, which, you know, the comm messages you see in current quests all the time. And as I was saying, you can customize their data. The image on the little left is from the quest builder, and it shows what he's going to say is written, and then it appears in the comm when they actually run through your quest. It's very cool. Very exciting. And over time, we hope to add other ways to the chronic system to allow these guys to be iconic characters in your quests. Rewards. There will be rewards. In addition to the rewards you can place into the chronicle yourself, there will be some available through the system, so that as you finish the quests that others create, and you have to go finish your quests, basically at both ends, you will earn the ability to get some really nice other rewards that are exclusive to the Chronicle system, such as Pod Racer and this extremely cool Sandcrawler house. This is a building that doesn't move, but it is a building that you can place and decorate and just like any other house. It's extremely cool. When I first saw it, I was amazed at how good a job our artist did on that day. It's really nice. All right, we're going to show you a quick demo of the system in action. Musical chairs.
Yeah, good stuff.
Okay, I'm just gonna show a very quick version, and then we'll open it up to.
I'll talk. You drive.
All right.
All right, so what Mike's going to do here is he's actually going to go to the button bar, and there's going to be a little quest builder option there now that brings up the quest builder. And he can go to this little combo box here and actually sort his tasks based on what type they are, comm tasks, for example, right here. So he's going to add a message from Han Solo. Well, he's going to change his quest title first. If you actually notice in the top right, just a little quest info section, you'll see it says level 1 right now and task 1. That's because comm messages don't really have a level. I mean, there's no threat involved with a comm message. Yeah. So as soon as he starts adding more tasks, that level will increase. It goes by the highest task level in your quest. So. Always blame the Night Sisters.
They're always causing problems.
They're a great band. Tina Turner and the Night Sisters.
So as you can see, there's an awful lot you can customize completely to whatever you want.
So every task can have a title, every task can have a description, and then certain other tasks require additional information, like a comm task.
All right.
So we have a comm task. What are you going to add now?
I'm going to go to
you're going to go to somewhere. So now he has a comm task, and then he's going to follow it up with a go-to location, which is going to take him to a Night Sister stronghold.
Okay. Then we'll put on...
Oh, you notice your go-to location made your task, or your quest is now level 88.
Yep. It's because the Night Sister area is considered a high-level area. You want to be the appropriate level.
So some tasks, especially kill tasks, will say, oh, you know, go kill 10 of whatever, but many allow you to specify exactly how many you want a person to kill. And for example, this kill and loot task, Mike can not only specify the number of Night Sisters he wants someone to kill, but also they have to loot some type of item, which he's typing in now, and he's giving it a drop rate of 80%. So there's really a lot of control in the player's hands for this system. Mike can type.
Sometimes. And we'll just finish it off with another one. One more comm. Actually, you know what? We'll just leave it at that. That's good enough.
So are you going to add any rewards here?
Yeah, I'm going to add a reward. Let's see.
So besides the rewards that the system gives you normally, of course, you can add your own. So Mike's going to add top 7 on this one.
How about a Tuscan rifle, because that's completely appropriate.
A Tuscan rifle, sure.
And then some credits.
And some money.
All right.
Okay.
So now I'll create this quest. At one point, you'll be able to say, at some point, you'll be able to say this is a draft, like I was saying, but that's not in yet. So it's going to make it directly into a hologram, which goes into my inventory. From here, you can view the rewards to see if the player added any rewards to it. The crafts, so you can see what's there. It says you have received. So there's some minor bugs involved. This is an early version. QA hasn't even looked at this yet, so we have some issues ourselves. And some polish. But then, just to take the quest, all I have to do is activate it. And there's Han Solo talking to me. There it is in the...
That's
great. Fan. There it is in the helper in the journal. So now it's telling me where to go next. The Sister Stronghold. Also, when you activate a quest, it goes into your beta pad as an object. So from here, you could abandon it if you still chose and start again. But I'm going to run over to where the Night Sisters are. There, little demo already has some spots that are set up to kind of simulate the locations you can go to for the tasks that we already have in. There's only a small subset of the task, just to kind of make it a little easier. But they're all around, so you can find people to kill and the locations to go to actually test your quests. So I'm at the right location. Now I have to find the culprit. I think it's this Night Sister Elder. I should probably equip a weapon. These guys are actually set up so that you don't have to kill them. They're just going to give you credit randomly as you shoot them, just to help things out. So I found this one that had the badge for Han Solo, and now I can raid it, or I can not raid it. From here I can raid it again because I skipped it. I'll give this one a 2, because it's really kind of a bad quest. And then I can claim my rewards. So that's a quick overview, but more importantly, this is available for you guys to play with in the Crossroads, so that you guys can actually try it out and give it a shot and tell us what you think, and just take it for a test run. All right, I guess we're ready for questions.
Shoot.
So will you be able to make a template if you want to reproduce the same quest over?
That's where the drafts will come in. It's not in yet, but that will be the way you do that. There'll be a system for you to save it. Not only save your quest so that you can iterate on it and change it if you need to, but also test it yourself. So if you want to do a quick run through without having to make a lot of run, you can do all that.
Okay, so if I make the template, then I can produce multiple quests.
You can, right, you can, from that you can create holocrons as you wish. We don't have that system completely hashed out yet, but there, yes, from there you will make the actual holocrons that other people will use.
So the holocrons and relics, like you want to set up a task to kill 20 Chubas, I assume you have to go out and kill a Chuba until you get the loot drop, the relic for killing Chibas.
So the question was if you want a task to kill Chibas, you have to go kill other Chibas until you get the relic that gives you that task. Potentially, but it may not be limited necessarily to only falling from Chubas. Some generic ones, or lower level ones, I guess I should call them, may come from various sources. Also, there will be, as you progress through the storyteller profession itself, there will be certain relics that we grant you, kind of as starter kits, more or less, so that you get those.
Plus, we also expect players to kind of sell and trade them amongst themselves, so... If you're a combat person and you don't really care about relics, but you have a buddy who does, maybe you throw them on the bazaar and you just give them out to them. So we expect there to be a player market as well for this.
Rating window. I think if you added below or above the actual rating system, an editable window where you could type in comments and incorporate that in with in-game email system. Have it automatically send the email back to the creator so they can get, you know, not only numerical, but like, oh, this was bugged or this is really nice. I think that would really work out well.
I agree. There is a problem with storing all that data and getting it to them whether they're online or not.
Okay.
There's some issues. This is probably going to be a starting point with a number. And then from there, as we're able to expand it, we'll look into doing that. But yeah, that's a good idea.
I run RP on Shadowfire. This is the greatest thing you could have given me.
I'm glad to do that. We're hoping that you guys will have a lot of fun with it.
And I do have a question. When you mentioned the iconic characters, would my players have the ability to say Han Solo comes and fights alongside them?
Well, as stated right now, it's limited to the com messages, but we do want to look into other ways to include the iconic characters in the future. We don't know what that'll be yet, but those kind of things could definitely be discussed.
You guys did A-number 1. This is awesome.
Cool. Well, thank you.
If the people up front, they can ask their questions, but if you can't hear in the back, we can repeat it, but I'm going to walk around with
mic. How are you dealing with exploits, credits, XP, that kind of stuff?
Well, those are going to be ongoing concerns right now. We haven't really looked into the balance of those kind of things too closely, but it's something that we discuss constantly. Such as the cost of what's going to take to put in these, because there can't be a system where you freely create an infinite number of objects, right? There has to be some sort of limit just so we don't crush our database, if nothing else. That's going to be an ongoing concern. We're going to try to balance it as closely as possible so that it's fair and fun. We don't want to make it so that it's just a grind, but we do want it to be a fun, fair system so that as you get your rewards, it's fulfilling.
No, I was going to take a question from the little kid in the red shirt. Question is, are we going to be able to let you make your own NPC as the quest giver? Maybe in version 2.0, not right now, just because we'd have to come up with a good way of doing maybe something like the image design system, maybe not, I don't know. There's just some details to work out with that, but I think that's a really cool idea, sure.
Just to add to that, again, this will probably not be in the launch version, but the idea is that this could tie in really closely to the storyteller system, so storyteller NPCs that you're able to place could very well, in a future version, be an NPC that you can use as a quest giver maybe, or a quest target, or something along those lines.
We have a question over here.
Could we use this system maybe in NPC cities that aren't being utilized, or, you know, like, places that, you know, POIs and stuff like that?
Oh, absolutely. The quest targets, like the Night Sister Stronghold that I showed, the one I went to was just a fake version. It actually, the actual real relic version will point you directly to the actual Night Sister Stronghold, where you can actually kill Night Sister Elders there to get quest credit, or the sentries, or the protectors, or whoever. So, absolutely.
I can call somebody over that side of this alternate back and forth.
Is there going to be a duration on this, like so much time to fulfill these quests set by the quest maker or in general?
At one point we talked about putting a timer on there. That probably won't be in the initial version, but it is something we have talked about, having a time limit that you could set.
All right.
I'm sorry, the question was would there be a duration or a limit, like a time limit that you could put on somebody's completing the task?
You got one right here. Okay, just so I'm clear, the quest relics are not one-shot items. They are more like a collection items, where once you get it, you always have it and are able to use it.
To be determined on that one. We're right now, we're using a consumption model, so one relic gives you one task. But we're thinking of, that might get a little tedious for some people, so we're thinking of having a couple that aren't, you know, infinite use and stuff. So it's something we're still working out. I mean, that's kind of why we wanted it here today for feedback, so.
The cost involved, when you make a quest, in order to make more of them, basically, we don't want you to have to just grind out more and more relics. So we want to find a balance between collecting relics and having that be fun and making quests. The end result is the creation and playing through of these quests should be the fun part. That should be the accessible, fun aspect of the thing above and beyond everything else. And hopefully the rest will be fun as well, but we don't want to have to force you to grind out a bunch of relics, basically, just to continue to make quests. So we don't know what the answer to it is yet. We're constantly discussing that in long meetings.
Someone from the other side over here.
Okay.
Speak about
our back, maybe. Do you have any plans of cross-integrating this with the storytelling? So you can have, like, for example, do a scavenger hunt or kill some of the spawned NPCs or win a pod race under a certain time or something like that?
The question was if we're going to integrate this system into the storytelling system. I would like to see them work well together. To begin with, it'll probably be a little more limited, but it is something we'd like. I see these storyteller NPCs potentially being either targets or quest givers, maybe, or some of the things like you suggested, pod racing, having them just be part of your quest or whatever. I think that is a natural progression for this, so that is something we'd like to see.
Spawn a blueprint or something.
Yeah, I don't know exactly how it will take shape, but absolutely, the storyteller system and the chroma system are too, they seem like they go together too well to ignore that.
Here you go.
Can the system be used for space content?
Not at launch. Again, that's something that's not in the initial version. There's a lot of things that won't be in the initial version that we want to add that we think are exciting and we've discussed. That's another one that won't be in the initial version, but it's definitely something we can look at adding.
We'll back off of you if you did, though. The sooner you do, the more we'll back off.
I'll keep that in mind. That's good to know.
Star Wars is space. I mean, you got to have space.
Oh, I agree. I agree that space is integral to the game. It should not be ignored. At the moment, her question had many parts. It had to do with entertainers and failing the quest, basically. Is that correct?
Yeah,
crafters and entertainers. I didn't show you all of the relic versions or the tasks we have available. There is actually a perform task that is for entertainers, so that you can require them to go perform at a certain location for a certain amount of time, maybe even specify they have to dance, they have to perform music, things like that. There's also a crafting one where you can require them to craft certain items. This is just the beginning. As far as failing a quest, you can't really fail them at the moment. If we ever put in the timer that was asked about earlier, that could potentially be a failure case. Right now, if you abandon the quest, it will be bio-linked to you at that point, and you can restart it right from the beginning because it's potentially something you purchased. We don't want you to be able to lose that, basically, without finishing it. So right now, there's really not a way to fail these. But again, that's something that makes it more fun and interesting. It's something we could potentially look at in the future.
I have a question back here in the back.
Oh, sorry.
Yes. Is this going to be designed to create quests for groups to complete and have a group difficulty?
Yes, there's actually a group difficulty. Do you have any group difficulty tasks?
Here we go.
So actually, if you look on the top right, here we go. So if you look in the top right, there's a little require section, and so this quest actually requires group combat, crafting, and social.
Awesome combination.
It's a hodgepodge.
Just to complete the list, we also have PvP. This one only requires you to kill a certain number of players who are like captain rank, but there are plenty of other options like battlefields and HQs. You have to, so there's a lot of possibilities here that we can take advantage of.
So on the right, let me get to see. So the question was, how long can a quest be, and can we make them prerequisites to other player-generated quests?
Yes.
Or off NPC quests. Mike?
There's no plan to make these connected to NPC quests. And as far as limiting, like having a prerequisite, we're going to try to leave that as much in your hands as possible. For example, there's no reason you couldn't have one of the rewards for this quest be your next Holocron quest, so that they can kind of, you can kind of set them up that way. There will be a limit to the number of tasks per quest, because there's only a certain amount of, we don't want to overload the data, and it gets a little clunky. There are certain practical limits. But you can extend it by having a chain of Holocrons or something like that.
That's good.
It's 12-ish, is what Matt says. And
I have another question here in the back.
Is there going to be any safeguards to protect against any X-rated content and a spell checker?
I wish there was a spell checker because I could use it. We will use our profanity filter to try to minimize vulgarity and inappropriate content as much as possible. And we'll try to make that as vigorous as we can without stifling too much, but that is going to be a concern. That's where rating and probably customer service will get involved.
There's a way to report a quest or something.
That's going to be a concern, and it is a concern, I should say, and there's something we're going to try to minimize as much as possible without hopefully stifling too much what you can do with these things.
I have another question over here.
Yeah, is the quest giver responsible for the prizes, or is it a random that you can choose from for the quest that you're creating?
I'm sorry, say that again?
When you create a quest, are you responsible for the items that you put as rewards, or can you choose from a list?
Does
the quest giver have to have the rewards already in order to give them out, or is there something you can choose from?
So for these boxes here, this you will input completely on your own. That's an item you are going to put into it, so you have to have the item. As far as the rewards that are generated by the system, such as the Sandcrawler House, those will be earned based on the quality of the quest. So the higher the quality of the quest based on the system we're going to put in, then the more you're going to get towards getting the better rewards that are generated by the system itself. So you won't have any direct control over that, but you will, based on how you make your quest, make those more available.
Eric, question. Right.
Hi, I've been playing Galaxies for the past 6 years, and a lot of times we hear about that movement from over this article limit, what can be done with iconic characters such as Darth Vader, but yet in this you're saying that we can add content for Darth Vader and other iconic characters to speak. What changed that we were able to get this, and can we see more changes like this in the future?
We have a guest panelist, so we'll take this question.
I'll take this question. I want to say that Lucas Licensing and LucasArts are very excited about it. Lucas Licensing is really excited about it. They're the ones who encourage us to use the iconic characters. As far as things have changed, it's not much. I mean, just literally, we're responding to the players. We know what the players want. Everyone's iconic stuff. We're putting iconic stuff in. Now we're putting it in your hands. You can put that iconic stuff in. You can play alongside stuff. You can make them speak for you. You can tell your story for you. So that's actually the big selling ticket with this, in our opinion, is you can make Vader say this. You can make Jabba say this. So I wouldn't say anything's really changed. It's more of a, we're opening it up more for you guys so you can enjoy your Star Wars experience a lot more. That answer the question?
Just to take that one quick step further, we have a sample of what one of the ways we want to use these guys in here is. I need to turn it on.
Even this technology pales in comparison to the power of the Force.
Oh, we can do our own voiceovers.
Okay, that sound was way too low, but basically there was a nice voiceover of Darth Vader saying the text that was in his box. That's one of the ways we want to use these things to make it really immersive and cool.
Make our own geeky voices.
As Jesse said, it's something we're all of us, both those of us at SOE and at LucasArts, are really excited about.
That's cool.
I have another question over here, and I'll keep working around the room, so if your arms are getting tired, just periodically raise them back, and I'll make it over to you.
As far as like where the PvP goes, could you make something like these things profession-specific, like suppose collect a specific bounty?
Mike?
Professions, well, in some ways they are, because there's combat, there's social, and there's... crafting quests? There were crafting quests?
He wants PvP.
Huh? Oh, the PvP ones?
He wants a PvP for profession specific, like go kill so X amount of spies.
Oh, sure, potentially. I mean, as far as the PvP tasks go, whatever seems to make sense, we could potentially add to the system. At the moment, it's basically just based on rank, and I think we have one in for destroying HQs, but that's not to me say that it has to be limited to just those. Anything that potentially makes sense could potentially become part of the system if it sounds like it would be a worthwhile task.
All right, here on the front. Since you guys are making this a new profession, it's going to limit a lot of the player base. So I'm wondering what kind of ideas you guys have as far as expertise for this new profession. How is that going to tie into this new system? Because Storyteller's always been available to everybody.
Well, this is still available to everybody, but it will encourage you to... the profession will just be a way to show it as you get better and garner certain rewards and things like that. It's not a profession. It's more like the politician. It's not really a profession that is limited by like expertise or anything like that. It's going to be available to everybody.
That's good.
I just had two. When are you guys looking to put this on test center? How soon are we looking? And you mentioned that we loot the items to start it. Is that right? Did I understand that correctly?
Actually, the plan will probably be to give you a certain amount of starter relics, just probably from a published gift, or maybe as your profession kickoff, as you go start the profession. We haven't completely determined how all that will work, but there will be some sort of booster kit that starts you off.
Okay, full of relics. If it is a lootable item that in the future happens, keep in mind that not everybody is a combatant.
Understood.
So the event storyteller community is made up of a lot of our peers, so keep that in mind.
Sure. Well, and in combat, maybe doesn't make as much sense for a crafting relic or an entertainer relic anyway, so there will probably be other ways to get those, either in addition or instead, depends on how it makes sense.
So how soon are we
looking? When it's ready.
Not soon trademark, but I mean, obviously you guys will be able to play it today, so I mean, just take that into account, I guess.
Right, here we go, right here.
Yeah, we just saw the Darth Vader voiceover. How is that generated, and will players be able to do the same kind of thing with all the iconic characters?
Might be an answer that way.
I turned it up, I swear to you. Did I? Oh, well, I'm not very good at these things. Alright, anyway, to answer your question, the voiceover ones will be generated because we would have to have voiceover that matches what they say. As far as the way they're going to be given out, it's probably, we don't know yet, honestly. It could be, these will probably be a little more special, so they could be promotional, they could be,
not TCG.
Who knows?
I
don't have an answer to that at the moment, sorry.
I have two requests. One, let us do things on Kashyyyk and Mustafar and some of the planets.
Both are on there.
Great.
There's actually, that'll be a flag that'll show, so if somebody needs to go to Kashyyyk, the quest will let them know that.
Okay. And two is, let us have Chewie and Wookiee NPCs that do the voices of the Wookiee NPCs on Kashyyyk that make the little Wookiee noises.
Or Locke will just do
absolutely.
It.
Absolutely.
Yeah. The Vader, too.
I think Locke just volunteered to record all the Wookiee. Yeah, so we're good to go.
Yeah.
Okay.
Right.
Does Vader have that
Kashyyyk expansion? Just give it to everybody.
Not everybody, believe it or not.
Yes.
Yeah. Majority does. That's one of the reasons for the tag, is so people will know.
Another question in the back. Go ahead.
Yeah, well, this system actually integrated with like smugglers for like the contraband system, so they can run the contraband missions also and actually get their rewards for that.
If I understand, the question was about the contraband missions that currently exist for the smugglers.
Yeah.
Currently, those are not included as part of the system, but again, the one of the ideas with the Chronicle system is that it's the future expansion is based on limited by our imagination, essentially. So potentially anything can become part of it, including the profession-specific tasks. Here's another one here.
How about in front?
Oh, you're in the front. Go ahead.
Are you going to have a method for us on searching for these on the bazaar that's not just going to show, like, miscellaneous holocron or Shulman?
The question was... Oh, wait, sorry.
Oh, and the other thing is, please leave TCG loot out of this.
The two questions. Well, one question and one, I guess, order.
Oh, I said please.
He didn't say please, I'm sorry.
Request.
Request.
To keep the TCG out of it. Well, at the moment, there are no specific plans to use the TCG. I'm not going to say that won't change, but right now... And the other question was...
it's more important, actually. Yeah.
Yeah.
The bazaar,
right? I was lost for a second.
No, sorry.
We actually have... currently, the plan is to remake the bazaar a little more robust to allow for better search so that you can find quests and other things based on better criteria.
Stats, too?
Potentially.
DevH is working on it.
It's something DevH is looking into.
That's good.
So absolutely, we want the bazaar to make not only trading the relics and quests themselves more easier to do, so that you can find the ones that you want,
based on
reading or whatever. Okay, go ahead, Roger.
Yeah, I was just wondering, are we going to get badges for either completing so many quests that players have made or creating so many quests that players can do?
The question was about badges for completing so many quests and various other aspects of it. Certainly, we've talked about that. It's not something that's in at the moment, but I don't see why that would be a problem. Sounds like a cool idea. How about up front?
What's that item? Where do I get it?
Which item?
It's screen you put in.
Oh. You don't, I guess, at the moment. It's just a quick bit of decoration.
You send Mike a PM. And he'll look it up for
you. And I'm send those a lot. If it's a decorative item you're requesting, then we can, you know, we could look into that and get sure. Maybe it'll be a reward for one of these things or something else.
All right, I'll go in the back here.
Just to.
Is there any?
There we go. Now it's solved.
Is there any systems in place to prevent me from creating a very easy quest and putting it back to tank as a reward?
Well, if you want to make a really easy quest and give a whatever kind of expensive reward that you choose, that's up to you. As far as the rewards we are going to generate, if it's a low-level, non-difficult quest, it's not going to really go much towards earning those other rewards. Better and longer quests, more variety, a little more difficult, that is how you'll earn more towards getting the generator rewards. But there's no limit to what you can put in there yourself.
Yeah, this guy's really ready for his quest.
Hey, I see you got rewards and stuff like that, and I see you do your own quest. I was thinking, don't you think players are just going to do really easy quests, do them themselves, get rid of their guild members, collect all the rewards, and then gather this thing back to us? Or is there going to be like some randomness? Is there anything to stop that?
Well, doing really easy quests will not really benefit you. That's one of the goals. It will either benefit you very, very, very negligible amount, or it'll be really small.
If the players just rate everything at 10, they can just get all the rewards right away. Right?
Well, the rating will have more to do with the XP you earn and how other people view your quests than it will the rewards you get from it.
But if you give a quest to your guildies and other friends, they just have 10,
you won't get any rewards for that, though. The only reward you get if they give you a 10 is you'll level up just a little bit faster in your progression through the Chronicle Master Saga, the Chronicle Master Profession. But you will not get a better, faster chance of getting the Sandcrawler Paw or anything like that. That's actually generated via how well that quest is rated. Not rated like by players, but rated by the system. Pull up your...
Yeah, I was just going to add that rewards are already given out before the rating screen even comes up.
No, not that. Pull up the book quest builder for me, Mike. I'll show you what I mean. So up in the top right corner where it says Quest Info... There's a level there and there's tasks. That's all generated via some data we put on there, each relic. And a part of that, Mike's putting in some back-end stuff to where it checks to see how complicated that quest is, how difficult it is, and based on that is how the system's going to generate the actual system-generated rewards that you'll get. It will have nothing to do with how well somebody rates you. It won't be any, it'll be the system generates how well they feel that quest was developed. All the rating will do is help how you grow as a Chronicle Master. And it won't have anything to do with your getting your Sandcrawler Pop Master. Yes, you can see, I can see a guild doing the old Fight Club stuff where everybody just lines up and takes the quest and gives a 10, and that guy, yay, he's Master Chronicle Master with nothing. He's just the master with nothing. It's like being level 90 wearing your newbie clothes. It's just that. You won't get the big fat reward. You'll just be able to make maybe a little more in-depth quests, but you don't necessarily get the reward.
And having a high rating doesn't really... It only means as much as what people buy into it. So if you put out a highly rated quest and a bunch of people run through it and they decide this isn't a very good quest, the rating is eventually going to go down.
Also, a big thing about the rating is we're trying to think of a way where we can incorporate it with the community and maybe feature top highest rated 25, you know, quest creators on all the servers, so people, you know, get a little more advertisement and have people coming up to you and asking for your quest specifically. So the rating's more for you guys to prevent you from buying a poor quest rather than, you know, rewards or anything.
And the bottom line there is we want it to serve you. That rating needs to serve you guys as much, best it can. So if it's not, then we will look at ways to improve it.
A new question right here.
I've got two questions here. Does your title thing call it there? Is that also going to include instances?
I'm sorry?
Instances like TK or something so that you can have so many warlords or something?
Sure, potentially. I mean, we talked about having a task to maybe kill the Hand of Fate or Exarchun or IG-88 or whatever. Those are all potential tasks, sure.
And the other one is, probably, will the badge collection, if you incorporate one, will that be on a progressive state so that as a Master Chronicle, like a Jedi cloak, you can earn up to like maybe 10 badges or something like that?
Possibly. Honestly, that's not something we've really looked at yet. I don't know how the badge part of it would work out.
Yeah, right now we've been working on the actual mechanics of building this quest builder and giving you guys the tools to build the quest. So here at Fanfare, y'all can play it, give us the feedback we want. All the extra fluff stuff like badges and all that, that's all comes later. That's something we want to add, but we want to get the core mechanic in, get the very basic level in so we can build upon our base foundation and make it better as we go.
Exactly.
Another question.
Hi guys. I was wondering, as far as the loot items, is there a way that we can have some sort of stick that will tie a TCG loot card to an item that you can put as a reward?
No. I didn't hear that, but I hear lots of no's.
Not right away.
Your own loot card?
His own loot card, yeah.
Probably not.
Well, no, I'm saying that current loot card, say I get the XJ4 air
speeder, and
I
want to put
it in here.
Well, I can't do it for the TCG, so can we just
stick where I can tie that
loot
card into a
in-game
stick that
makes. Why would
that
be bad? I mean, it's his choice to do that. So
I don't know. I'll let Jesse make that decision.
I don't think the system supports it at the moment, and Matt would have to work probably overtime to get that to actually work. So, sure, I'm up for it.
Here's another question.
Okay, so to get this right, or my understanding of it, first, before you can do anything, I mean, you'll give us a base set of relics to kind of try. But to get the higher level stuff, we're going to need to loot the relic. And it'll be a one-use item, and we can create a plan around it that we'll be able to sell or use to one group of people or one person, depending on the level. Is that correct?
That hasn't really completely been determined. That's what I was mentioned a little bit earlier, that we don't want you to have to continue to just grind out a bunch of relics in order to distribute your quests. So we're still working on determining what the cost of creating a quest will be, actually. So that's, but we don't want it to. We want to find a fun balance, basically. So it's fun to collect these things, and it's then fun to make the quests, but it doesn't become a drag to try to distribute it.
Yeah, just to add on that, like the kill, we have Kill Creedle on here. I would hope that would probably be an infinite use one, but kind of the higher level, more rare ones, like, you know, Destroy Exarchun, That would probably be a one-time use thing that he dropped. So, I mean, it's just trying to find a balance right now.
But even that is completely up for discussion. We're still having meetings about that.
Here's that question.
The iconic characters is a really great system everyone's wanting for the game, but what about making this more personal to immortalize your own character, kind of make everyone get to know your character a little bit? Are you going to be able to like just put generic weapons or custom races that are in your game, things like that?
Oh, questers. Absolutely. Notice there's a comment here from just a generic knight sister. Oh yeah, the other races as well. This is just a small sample, but sure.
Or are you talking like you want your player to appear in the window? Your
player. Yeah.
There's a few tech problems with that because if your player's online, we can't get his equipment. So there's a few hurdles there. Ideally, yeah, it'd be cool. I just don't know right now. No. No, there's just tech hurdles. I'm not sure what the good answer tech-wise is for that, but I would hope that would be where the comm system would go after Iconics is, to personalize a little more and show your player.
Do it.
That would be really cool.
Yeah. Do it. You can do it.
Really?
Right, another question.
As far as iconic characters, are you guys planning on having like an extensive list of iconic characters, like Nim and some of the guys from some of the expanded universe, Mara Jade, all those guys too? And another question is, can we give GCW as a reward too?
The first question was about iconic. Potentially, any character in the expanded universe could potentially show up as someone in this comm as long as they're appropriate to our timeline. So, absolutely. It's limited to what we put in. I imagine we'll probably start with a certain set, and then we'll just add to it. As far as the second part, the GCW rewards, I guess you're saying points, GCW points? That could make sense for the PvP ones, sure. It doesn't support that at the moment, but that is something we could look at and discuss.
I remember last year, there was a thing that came up that I was wondering if there would ever be a way that you guys could incorporate the different playing styles into this game so that everybody can interact. And it seems like you guys have finally done it, where you can have, as far as what I'm seeing, you can have a PvE quest where you can actually incorporate some PvP. Is there a way also where you can have these quests interact with other players so that the RP community would actually have some bearing in this too, where they would have to interact with somebody to send them on to the next part of the quest?
So if what you're asking is, could a task be to speak to another player or interact with another player, basically?
Yes.
It's an interesting idea.
Well, where you incorporate all the playing styles of the game into one thing.
Yeah. In some ways, there's some things we can do. We have to discuss it and figure out what makes sense. But it's an interesting idea to actually have a task that is... Because right now we already have one PvP kill another player, but maybe other interactions with players that are less violent. Sure. That's a cool idea.
You have to dance flourish for an entertainer.
Or maybe use a specific social...
Or show Mr. Bubble your ribbons, that kind of thing.
Right. Yeah, that's a cool idea. I think I definitely something we'll bring up and discuss because I like it.
In the back again.
This kind of follows this question over there, but kind of putting RPG in it, like having a smuggler taking his group past a certain spot of outer space, or having a Jedi cloak to another place to open up doors for the whole team to get, you could get connect quests together with different classes. Could that be formatted into this storytelling or quest?
Potentially. Again, that's probably beyond our launch scope. Having interactions of those kinds could be pretty robust and cool. It's just a matter of figuring out how we can incorporate them into this system. But those are great ideas. I mean, the feedback like that is exactly the kind of thing we're looking for, especially as we progress past the first version and we're looking for things to add.
Can you do your own quest?
Yes, absolutely.
I just ran through mine. Didn't enjoy it. I should have made it with the rest.
That was awesome.
Also, with the recipe system, you'll be able to run your own quest without it actually costing you anything. So you can run it, change it, run it again until you're happy with it. So.
Another question here. Will the comm messages come up for just the individuals using it, or if they're grouped, will it go across the whole group?
Currently, that's just for the individual on the quest. There's no shared group support at the moment. That would be something that we'd have to add at a later date. If it, as it made sense, having actual, like accepting a group quest that your entire group accepts, that can be interesting, but that's not going to be something in the initial version.
Last question.
The entertainer missions aren't really that extensive or great, but this it could be the potential to make entertainer progression a lot more. So for a reward, could it possibly be entertainer experience? Like go here, perform, but also talk to this person. Do like a little bit of espionage, spy type thing, and then go over here and perform or something. You get some entertainer experience for it.
Certainly, at the moment they're just perform tasks, but any way we can have both crafters and entertainers have more interesting things to do within this system is absolutely something we want. When we give XP, we're going to try to base it on the types of actions within the quest. So, that, yeah, if it's all social events, go perform and go do entertainer type actions, you will get entertainer type experience. I think that's it. Are we done?
We'd be able to do like question and answer, like an NPC, you can answer an NPC's question with like five different answers or something.
The question was, can we have basically a conversation with an NPC that can kind of have different outcomes based on what you say or what you do. Not in the initial version, but we have talked about actually having a way for you to write conversations for NPCs, probably storyteller NPCs.
Yeah.
That would be the base of it, and that's something that will be a future version.
Real quick, before you walk out, I have a limited number of these flyers that some nice folks have made a quest to do while you're here. There's a limited number of t-shirts for people that completed, but we'll do some type of badge. For it, if you get all your information, put it on the back of the piece of paper, give it to one of these people with the t-shirts here, and they'll get it to me, and just what something else to do while you're here.
Okay, I think that's it for now, but this will be available at Crossroads for you guys to look at and actually play with, and we will be available for more.